And there's light on the bottom, so the thing is lit, so it's like really heroic. And then there's sort of like a, on the glass, on the back level of the glass is like what side of the building is. So it might say northwest, and then on the top of the glass, the directory is screened over it. So you're looking at this sort of like really beautiful sculptural layered typography. As I started doing signage, there were either things put on buildings, cut into flat surfaces, or painted around things. And then this new iteration, both jazz and this, are sculptural, which is sort of sort of nice. When I started designing jazz, I met with Witten. I asked him what he thought should be reflected in the logo, you know, because I always look for some hook of a basis of being able to give back somebody's values to them visually. And he said, well, it should be syncopated. And I said, well, what does syncopated mean? And he says, well, syncopated is when you got a bunch of things in order and one of them's off. So I had done these deliberately thin letter forms and then filled in the A because these were all in order and this was off. And then when I said, he said another comment about jazz guys being a little bit off. And I said, sort of like square pegs and round holes. And everything inside the space is based on squares and circles because the A has a square and a circle. We did that, so when I played him back to him, he could fall in love with it. Would paint the typography on top of it by hand. And that's the way you used to present that stuff before the computer. And that was my craft. My craft was making comps. And I used to make all kinds of beautiful layered mechanicals that I've saved of the days that I used to use my hands. So the computer made me feel like my hands were cut off because you don't type a design. That seems dumb. There's gonna be a moment, and it's actually gonna be a really short moment in relationship to all this other garbage you got to do to get to the point that you get to make the stuff. But that's the thing that I kind of live for. You know, like there's like this one moment where you figure it out and you get it and you think it's going to be the best thing you ever did. And it's like really, really exciting. And I never get over it. And it hasn't changed in 34 years. And as long as I can feel that, you can do it.